and welcome, Aloha. This is Pastor Jonathan Steeper from Kalihi Union Church. Do you ever feel like life has gone upside down? That the way things were has changed so much that it's like your feet are in the air and your head's on the ground, and you don't know which way is up anymore? The values that you once held as being true and immovable have all of a sudden been switched and completely reversed. You know, I remember as a child, my parents teaching me that if you wanted to show respect and honor to someone when they came, you'd come and hold out your hand and say, "How do you do? My name's Jonathan. What's your name?" Now, if you do that, you're suspect. You're not supposed to do that. It used to be that criminals were the ones that wore the masks in the movies, and they were the bad guys robbing the banks. Now, if you don't wear a mask, you're a criminal. It used to be that governments were there to protect your freedoms. And now it's government that is determining that we no longer have those freedoms to make our own choices, our own values. It used to be that if you didn't work, you couldn't eat. And if you didn't work, you weren't rewarded for not working. And now they pay you not to work. It used to be that when someone was sick, we would all love on them and gather around them, but that they would be quarantined. Now, we've decided that healthy people have to be quarantined. And it was also in the days that you would, if you needed fresh air and sunshine, that was the place to find health and to grow and to stretch your legs. But now, it's supposed to be safer at home. Everything seems to get turned on its head. It used to be that you would run to church to gather with God's people to pray in a crisis. Now they tell you, "Oh no, you can't go to church. That's bad." Everything gets turned on its head. And today we're going to look at a passage of how God turns things right side up. And all of us feel like turtles on our back with our legs in the air. But God flips things right side up. And in Acts chapter 2, we're going to see something that transformed the world forever. As God came and invaded this upside down world, and maybe you feel like your life is upside down, and He came in order to put things right side up in the name of Jesus. He promised it, Jesus, before He ascended into heaven. He said, "You wait for the gift that the Father will give you. For when the Holy Spirit comes, you will receive power. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, all Judea, Samaria, to the ends of the earth." And now in today's passage in Acts chapter 2, we're going to see the Holy Spirit move in ways miraculously and powerfully to turn things right side up with Jesus at the head. Take a minute, open your Bibles, look to Acts chapter 2, and we're going to continue. I need to turn right side up. In Acts chapter 2, we see this transformation that takes place as the promise of Jesus is fulfilled in the coming of the Holy Spirit. It says, "When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place, and suddenly a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. And they saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. And all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit, and they began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them." The Holy Spirit, the promised gift of Jesus, the result of our forgiveness of sin, the redemption that was purchased on the cross, the result of Christ rising from the grave and ascending into heaven, is that now, by His atonement, we are able to have the Spirit of God come and dwell in our lives. Never before in history was this possible in this way. And so we want to look at Acts 2 and the transformation that takes place for salvation. We've talked about all our world's cries about being safe. and the whole world being turned upside down and on its head just to try to be safe. But God turned the world right side up, in order that we may be saved, and that in the salvation of Jesus Christ, we may find life and eternal life, safety in our relationship with God. But sometimes that means less safety here in the things of earth. Let's take a look at this amazing story. So they're all together in one place, and suddenly there's this sound. And I don't know what sounds you think of, but it's like a violent wind. And I've been in strong storms and thunderstorms. Some of you may be in hurricanes, but there is a deafening sound that comes with the wind that demonstrates this awesome power in nature that God has created. Well, this sound, it was like a violent wind. The Spirit is talked about like the wind in John chapter 3, where it goes where it wills. You cannot contain it. You can't tell where it comes from or where it's going. And it's like that with the Holy Spirit. You can't direct the Holy Spirit what he's going to do or when or how. And he comes in this power, and it's this powerful witness. Today there was a flyby, and it was a flyby by the National Guard in honor of all the first responders for the COVID. And there were these F-22s. And they were there, and they were flying over as 11:30, flying over the hospital. And the amazing thing about F-22s is you can hear them before you can see them, because they break that sound barrier. I mean, I've been told F-22s go a Mach 2 point something. Incredible speed and power. There's no plane like them on the earth. And I remember being on the aircraft carriers, and there weren't F-22s there. There were, I don't know if they were F-16s or whatever, and they were taking off. But just the roar of the sound, not only of those engines, but of the wind that comes out of them, incredible. And there was something of this, only on a far greater level, when the Holy Spirit came. It broke all barriers, caught their attention, and the Lord wants to catch our attention to turn us right side up, that he is wanting to do something powerful in our life that hasn't happened before. If you're living your life upside down right now, God wants to come, and he wants to turn you right side up. And it says here that he did it suddenly. He did it unexpectedly. You know that he can work when you least expect it. He can work in the times of silence. He can work in the times of crisis. He can work in the times when you're distracted and otherwise. But when the Holy Spirit comes and he gains your attention, your life will never be the same again. Pay attention to what the Holy Spirit is doing and wanting to do in you right now. And the Holy Spirit can completely, radically change your life today. You don't have to wait till tomorrow. You don't have to wait till you change and fix things up. You don't have to wait till you tidy up your living room. He can come and he can work suddenly to move you, your life, to be right side up in the name of Jesus Christ. He can transform you for Jesus. It was a sound like this violent wind, but it was from heaven. This was heaven invading earth. And the things of heaven, God is wanting to bring by his Spirit down into the very reality of your living room, of my living room, down to the reality to fill your home, to fill your family, to turn it, the relationships and all the values and the things you are living for and the efforts and the energies you're spending, to turn them right side up. He wants to come to you right now. See, this was the first event of the coming of the Holy Spirit. But this is the first of many, 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 many events until Jesus returns. And the Holy Spirit wants to come, and to come from heaven, and to come and fill your life today, this invading earth. Jesus invaded earth when he came and he was born as a little child. And then the Holy Spirit invaded earth when he came and gave birth to his church in Acts chapter 2. And one day the Lord Jesus will come and he will invade earth again, when he will come as king and as judge, and he will judge the world. But right now there is the power of heaven available to you and to me. In John chapter 14, 15, and 16, Jesus talks about the promise of the Holy Spirit.
The wonderful thing about Scripture is God tells us what He's going to do. He promises, and then He does it. Why? So that we can see, oh, He said you will receive power, and then you see it happen. So that then what He promises, we can trust that He's also going to do. So even before Jesus' crucifixion, He promised that the Spirit of Truth, the Counselor, the Paraclete, would come. And you see this in John chapter 14, where it says that the Holy Spirit would teach us. He would remind us the words of Jesus. And Jesus had just finished saying, I am the way, the truth, and the life. You see, into a world that's upside down with lies, the wind of the Spirit of Truth blows in to blow away the lies of the enemy and to bring the truth of that which is of Jesus Christ, that which is eternal, and to turn it right side up. Jesus also said in John chapter 15, He said that the Spirit of Truth would come and would testify, would witness about Jesus. Now remember in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, the promise that was that when the Holy Spirit came, we would be witnesses, and that we would be witnesses to the resurrection power of Jesus. And so with the Holy Spirit coming, He's testifying about Jesus, and then we are testifying about Jesus to the world. Then in John chapter 16, again, we have the Spirit of Truth who comes, and He says He convicts the world of guilt because we have not believed in Him. He convicts the world of righteousness because Jesus has ascended to the Father, and He convicts the world of judgment because the prince of this world, Satan, is already standing condemned by God. But then He says later on in chapter 16, verse 13, but when He, that's the Spirit of Truth, comes, He will guide you into all truth. He will not speak on His own. He will speak only what is hears, what He hears, and He will tell you what is yet to come. He will bring glory to Me, says Jesus. So here we have, in Acts chapter 2, this mighty rushing sound like a mighty wind from heaven to come and to bring the evidence of the Holy Spirit, the one of truth, who would come and blow away the lies of this world and the lies of our life and bring in the power and the truth of Jesus Christ. That's how our lives are turned right side up. And it filled the whole house. The whole house, they were sitting, they were praying, they were in the upper room, but the whole house is filled with the presence of the Spirit. Oh, that every part of our homes were filled with the presence and the power of the Holy Spirit to turn things right side up. That our computers would be used for the kingdom of God and not for the things of the earth. That our relationships between brothers and sisters would be turned right side up, where they're to be encouraging and helping one another. Relationships between husbands and wives, they'd be filled with the Holy Spirit and led with forgiveness and with grace and with joy. God wants to turn our homes right side up to make them places filled by the Holy Spirit. I'm going to continue in a minute. We're going to talk about two other things that happen in Acts 2 as the Holy Spirit comes in fire. You're going to see, I wore this shirt because it kind of looks like fire. But He comes with fire because there's so much more He wants to do. And then these tongues of fire come and transform these people in miraculous and wonderful ways. Join with me in the next section.